I'm Darren Barker.
And I'm Spencer Oliver.
I'm Sylvester Stallone.
I'm David Haye.
I'm Clarice.
I'm James DeGaulle.
I'm Angel Townsend.
I'm Carl Frost.
And this is The Live Show.
This is The Live Show.
This is The Live Show.
Hello and welcome to the live show. This week we've come down to Wales and we're with IBF featherweight champion Lee Selby.
What a great show we've got and a great guest, IBF featherweight world champions. Nice one, Lee. Remember, quick one, if you want to come on and ask Lee a question, remember again, up the top there somewhere, it will say request to chat. Click on and I can ask Lee or myself or Spencer a question. Also, we've got a signed glove by Lee that you can win. But you've got to request a chat and answer this question. And the winner will be picked in the end by random, by Lee himself. The question is, who did Lee beat to win the British featherweight title?
You're not going to win the glove if you text in along the bottom. You've got to press request a chat, which is in the top right-hand corner.
I'm in it. And Lee will pick one at random. So come up, answer the question. But Lee, good to have you on here, mate. Blinding performance the other week. You're looking a little bigger. How are you, mate?
Not bad. He's enjoying life. Leave him alone. He's enjoying life. I've got to tell you just quickly. Me and Lee done a show for Sky. We was doing a show at the weekend, Saturday night, stroke Sunday morning. You looked a lot smaller there, mate. I've got to be honest.
I'm still recovering from that. It feels like I've got jet lag or something.
You was on from what?
You did a long one, didn't you?
I'm usually in bed at 10 o'clock as well. I got to the studio at 8 and I got back home to my house 8 the next morning.
Brilliant. Yeah, now wicked show. And we're going to be talking about that. Russell Jr. was a good winner at the weekend and a future opponent of yours as well. So something we'll be talking about at the weekend. But let's start right at the beginning, mate. How did you get into boxing? What age was you and where did you start?
Well, I first went to the gym at the age of 8. Yeah. Well, I was forced to the gym by my dad. He's like a boxing fanatic. So as soon as he was old enough to put on my gloves, he sent us to the gym. I had my first fight at the age of 10. I had about 100 amateur fights.
Did you?
Yeah. I won about 70. But like, I weren't really dedicated. If I really applied myself, I probably could have beat everyone I boxed. Mm. I turned professional in 2008.
On your amateur career, did you win any amateur titles?
I just won the Welsh like national title every year. Right. I entered it. Boxed in the boys' clubs. Yeah. I won a fight in the boys' clubs, and the guy's trainer who I beat, he got me thrown out of the tournament. He said I boxed in a different age group or something.
Right.
He got me kicked out.
Right.
And then I boxed in the Four Nations twice. I got beat by Paul Appleby. Won in Scotland. They ripped me off. I won the fight, but they robbed me. And the other fight was in Wales. He beat me first square.
Did you box for Wales?
Yeah, not as much. My younger brother, he travelled all the whole world.
Yeah, we're going to pull him in. He's just sitting.
I'll poke.
I didn't do so much.
Right. Isn't that funny, though? Do you know, like, there's been a lot of fighters in the past that have done really well as professionals. Didn't really do much as amateurs. I mean, it's not an uncommon thing. You'd think that, you know, amateur boxers, the ones that are at the top, they don't always make it to the professional ranks. I mean, I know a lot of them do, but through the professional ranks, it's a totally different game, isn't it?
Yeah.
And we've seen it a lot. We've seen it so much.
I think if I applied myself like I did not, I could have been an elite amateur.
Right.
But I just didn't have the
you know, when you was younger then, you starting out, was it always an ambition to be a boxer, be a professional? Or was he just
starting off? No, we had no choice. Me and my brother.
No. Did your dad box, or was he just a fan?
He claims he boxed. There's no evidence, so he says he had 21. He lost one, but there's no trophies, no videos, no paper cuttings.
Oh, really?
We've got one here, Lee, just quickly, because it don't really fit in, but I'll say it anyway. Are you doing any appearances or meet and greets at all? Do you know? Is there any local Cheesecake Factory around here or something?
No, sadly, there's not. I'm thinking of opening up a cafe, a cheesecake and coffee. No, seriously. They're my two things.
You're serious?
Yeah, I love them.
You better stay away from it. You have to be barred.
I was looking in town for the place, but then Costa opened up a big coffee shop.
Right.
Yeah. So I didn't want to kill the Kill the market.
I can see it down there now. I can see it down there on Barry Island. We've just been down to Barry Island where Gavin and Stacey's.
How looked afterwards, we?
Oh, it was superb. Right, we were in a place called the Coffee Co. We said we was going to give them a shout out because they looked after us so much. But I can see it down there now. Can you see it? Lee Selby's cheesecake shop.
Yeah.
I can see it now.
And you got your meet and greet there. So guess 1806. There you go. You have a slice of cheesecake, a coffee, and you can meet Lee.
Wicked.
Ali Spratt, do you like being called the Welsh Mayweather?
No, I don't.
Oh, you don't?
The boxing news dubbed me it because I was traveling up to Vegas, sparring Mayweather's gym and stuff. So that's why I got the nickname. And my style is a bit boring like this.
I don't think your style is boring, mate. Talking about your style, let's start off the O2 on the undercard of the Anthony Joshua bill, where he won the world title, which was a great performance by Joshua. Equally good performance by yourself. I mean, boxing guy Eric Hunter.
Yeah, talking about Mayweather, he was like Mayweather.
He was. And that's why I was talking about
the same bloody facial expressions.
Oh, yeah.
But he could fight, man. He could fight. But the British public, they didn't really know it.
No, only the hardcore, real hardcore boxing fans.
Yeah, they seen the 3 losses on his record. Mm. Like, didn't look into it. But 2 of them were disqualifications.
Yeah.
So they ain't really losses. And he got beat by a decent kid.
Expectations there, isn't it?
I did my research and I knew he was a good fighter.
So you got caught in the second round. Was that the first time you've been over?
No, the canvas was a bit wet. And stuff. it was a good shot when I watched it back.
Yeah.
But I think I was a bit off balance. I weren't hurt. Luckily, like, my legs were fine, my head was clear. Otherwise, I'd still be questioning my chin now. But
No. Well, listen, it was a flush shot, and that kid could hit as well.
Yeah, watching it back, it was like a knockout shot. Like,
yeah, absolutely. Not many people would have got up from it.
But that is it. I think the test of your chin is not going down, it's getting up.
Yeah.
If you can get up.
Yeah. Good. Yeah, that was a wicked performance.
I know it's just moving forward a bit, but I'll just ask the question anyway, in case I get past it. Who would you like to fight next?
To be honest, I haven't.
Your personal preference.
An opponent in I'd prefer to fight. But luckily, I'm in a good division.
Yeah, you are,
probably the best in boxing at the moment.
And that's what you want, don't you? You want good opponents to be able to create the big fights, big money fights. You need people that can fight equally. And we worked on that show, didn't we, Russell Jr.? He can fight.
That's it. At the moment, everyone's calling me out. I'm like a wanted man.
He's got a bounty on his head.
It's that in the corner, you can't see it. There's a little red belt, a box with a red belt on it, and that's why everyone wants
it.
They
think I'm an easy test, weren't
they? All right. Okay, we're going to come in now. What historic fighter did you gain inspiration from?
Muhammad Ali.
There you go.
He was always on the TV. My dad was always watching him, so that's who we grew up watching.
Wicked. Any plans to appear on the O2? This 25th of June, the Joshua.
I haven't been given a date, but more than likely end of July.
End of July.
Maybe August.
Oh, another good one here. Is Cole Frampton a serious opponent for you next?
Yeah. He called me out recently after his last win.
That's a massive fight, isn't it?
That's a massive fight for the UK.
We're both
advised by Al Heyman, so the fight's easy to make.
Right. And he's talking about moving up as well, though, isn't he?
That's what I was going to say. He's just got to step up and wait.
So I know, because I've been down there with him a few times, been down there filming him a few times. And I know that he struggles like that to make super bantams. It's only a matter of time anyway. And I think that's the obvious fight for you two, because your profile's going through the roof. Do you know what I mean? You're boxing on these big shows now. His profile, Barry's doing a great job with him as well. Being massive.
If that fight got made, if the fight was offered to Frampton, I'm sure they'd take it. He's itching to go up to featherweight. If he can go straight up to featherweight in a huge domestic clash and fight for a world title, you're telling me he's not going to take it?
I heard he's in talks with Santa Cruz.
Oh, yeah.
So if they box, maybe even the loser first and then fight the win.
Yeah.
Both master fights. Right, what we've got here. So, Lee Selby, if you got the fight with Cole Frampton, do you beat him easy?
I don't beat him easy. He's a very good fighter. He's an elite fighter, world champion. But I think I'll beat him.
To answer that question a little bit as well, I think when you're boxing for the world title, the word easy doesn't really exist, does it?
Well, boxing before the fight, it's not.
Boxing in general, it's not easy.
Nah. I think people forget sometimes, the viewer, it's such a fine line between winning and losing a boxing match, isn't there? You've only got 2 arms, 2 legs. There's only so much you can do.
If you're a couple of percent fighting under par and he's a couple of percent fighting at his best, he's gonna win.
Right. So your favorite boxer is it Ali?
It changes at the moment.
Floyd Mayweather.
No, I do like him obviously, but at the moment it's probably Thomas Hearns. And I
returns.
General McLennan, I like him as well.
Yeah, I was at that fight when Ben.
Yeah.
In the fight with Ben when I was a kid, yeah.
I should have got stopped,
should have. Yeah, should have. The first round. Spencer was about 30 in that fight. No, he was about 40 minutes old. I've got to give Spencer some stick on the show night every week. Would you ever think about moving up to another weight?
Yeah, but like I said earlier, at the moment, the heavyweight division is the best in boxing.
You're doing right in the super middles at the moment.
my brother's a Leprince Azim.
All right, I can't remember what we're talking about there. You could be winning on points. Then get
right, let's go back. Just get back to the
remember, schedule. Request the chat, though, if you want to come on. And remember the glove winner. We've got it here.
There it is. Look at that little baby.
Lee beat to win the British featherweight title. Come on. Answer that question. But you've got to come on stage. You can't write it down the bottom there. And Lee will pick one at random. Yeah, go on, mate.
So let's go back to the beginning, Lee. So you had a good amateur career. Professional debut. Do you remember that?
No. Well, I know it was in 2008.
Right.
I think I boxed. Yeah, I boxed Sid Razor.
Right, Razor.
Yeah.
How did that go?
He's a proper journeyman, isn't
he? Yeah, he was tough. Yeah. Like, he was a lot bigger than me.
Right.
A fully grown man. I was only young.
Yeah.
I must have been more 21 or something. Like, the first couple of rounds, I pissed it. I was just boxing his head. Then, obviously, it was my first time fighting. It was either 4 or 6 rounds. I'm not sure. It might have been 6. Like, in the later rounds, then I started to tire a bit. And he just kept the same face. Every time I was catching him, his facial expression didn't change. And then at times I thought, what have I got
myself into? It's a shocker, isn't it? Do you remember your profession, David?
I do, because I thought, one of the things I remember about it, I thought Gaines was Howard Clark.
I remember
He's not too well now, so I went to Howard, and you're on the men. But he fought Fernando Vargas for the IBF middleweight or light middleweight title. He was a journeyman by the time I fought him. But when I told my dad that I was fighting Howard Clark, he fought for the world title, my debut, he was going, what? You're fighting Gaines for the world title on his debut? Jumped over 6 rounds, but I remember I couldn't crack an egg.
Yeah.
Crack an egg when I was there. I just turned
pro. It's a big shock, isn't it, of turning, going from amateur to pro. I boxed a geezer called Des Galgano, who had 103 fights, and I thought, here we go. But he'd only won about 23. And I thought, well, I'm going to go in there and bomb this geezer out. But he'd been in distance with Nazim Ahmed, and he'd been in distance with everyone. I found the reason out. He would have been a good 1,500-meter runner. The geezer just ran. His most frustrating time. I think your debut is always the hardest to shine.
A lot of pressure.
It was.
I was petrified. Lee, so I don't know if many people know this. You suffered a defeat early on in your career, didn't you?
You could call it a defeat.
Yeah, all right. That's what I was about to say.
We don't know.
I was the away fighter. I boxed a boy. I think it was Samir Munameh or something.
We couldn't pronounce his name. That's what we said. No, a geezer.
It's something like Samir.
Yeah.
And I boxed on his home show. The first round, he probably won.
Yeah.
The second round, I won.
Yeah, 4 rounder.
And the third and fourth, rounder. So before I even got going, I lost the first round. By the time I warmed into it, I think it was like 3 rounds to 1. If anything, he won one round.
Yeah.
We drew one, and I won the last two.
But in 2 years later, you won the British title. Yeah. I mean, that was the turning point of your career, really. Wasn't it? I mean, talk us through that. Who you boxed?
Well, when I won the British title, we offered that Samir. The first defence, second defence, third defence, fourth defence, he wouldn't take it.
Yeah, of course.
Really?
Yeah, of course.
But yeah, I boxed Stephen Smith. I was the away fighter.
Oh.
I was the away
fighter. Anyone will come up?
The dog. What's this?
So that was the answer. But look, you got that wrong, guest 1857. The answer's come up. It's the first one to come on.
Right.
Do you know what, Stephen? I'll tell you what. Stephen Smith, I'll rate Stephen. I know he was unlucky, and we'll talk about that after, but that was some shot.
Yeah.
Oh, that was a massive shot.
Something like,
yeah, you was.
Some of the rounds in the bookies, I was like under to one. To score.
Serious?
Yeah. So everyone from my hometown and like in Newport, South Wales, they were all putting their money on.
Mm.
And they all won a fortune.
Well, that was a well-seasoned amateur.
That was my breakout fight.
You must have known Stephen well, mustn't you? Did you know Stephen? Yeah, let's get Andrew in it.
I knew Callum Moore because when I got onto Team GB, Stephen was just coming off.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I'd seen him fight a lot, so I thought it was a tough fight.
It was a tough fight, wasn't it, on paper?
I knew my brother could beat him.
He'd done it, didn't he? There he is. There he is. Look,
You just give a question on it.
It don't matter. Don't matter. Come on in. Yes. Right, so where are we going now then?
We are going on 9 fights after you beat Smith. Yeah. 9 fights after you beat Smith, you was having a good little run, winning. You boxed for the world title. I mean,
banging people out. Yeah, well,
proper banging people out. Looking good. Boxing the world title against
Gradovich.
Evgeny Gradovich.
Yeah.
The Mexican-Russian.
Yeah. I was there that night, actually. It was a great performance, man. He was unbeaten at the time, wasn't he?
He was unbeaten. Yeah. I was his fourth mandatory, and his, I think it might have been his fifth defence.
Right.
He was IBF fighter of the year, the year before, so he was a very good fighter. But we'd been out to America, sparring with the Mexicans. They all had a similar style, just trying to walk me down, so I had the best preparation.
Mm.
And the fight just went to plan.
Yeah. And then you boxed was it your first fight out in America when you boxed your first defence?
Yeah, first defence.
Because he was a tricky guy as well.
Well, in his day, he was an elite fighter.
Yeah, three-time world champion.
Fernando Montiel, former three-weight world champion.
On the plane, weren't you? Straight over to, was it Arizona?
Arizona, yeah. Yeah. Well, me and my brother, we went out to LA for like a 2-week spare in, and then we flew over to Arizona.
Do you spar a lot, you two?
Yeah.
Still, even now? Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you main sparring partners? So do you spar with most?
Probably, yeah.
Yeah.
I've got to ask you this. Does it ever get heavy, the sparring, when you two spar?
Always.
Because I used to spar my brother a lot. And it used to be quite heavy.
I go all out. Because obviously, you can take shots.
Yeah.
And the enemy is just as hard on it. And then he says, but... You know, so I must sit hard.
Right, we've got another one here. How do you want to be remembered after your career in boxing? So we know your aspirations, sorry. So how do you want to be remembered and what your aspirations? How far do you want to go, mate?
I'd like to try and unify the title, beat another champion, and just be remembered as one of the great Welsh fighters. Already, I've put my name in the history books. I'm the 12th Welshman to win a world title.
Brilliant.
So I should always be remembered in Welsh boxing.
Do you spar with Lee Haskins a lot as well?
I've only ever sparred him once because he's a lot lighter.
Yeah.
Who was the toughest spar you've ever had? Who's the best kid you've ever sparred?
It sounds a bit cheesy, but my brother, he's technically the best.
Right.
But I've sparred some big guys.
He's holding 50 quid now.
Money's going under the table.
I've sparred... I was sparring like light heavyweights in Newport. The one time he caught me around the chin. I didn't go down, but I forgot where my kit bag was. I didn't know who I was sparring. And then when I left the gym, I forgot where I packed my kit. I still didn't go down.
You had one of them, didn't you?
I got dropped in Repton. I was light heavyweight. Yeah, so
he was a flyweight,
I was sparring, right? This African come down. He was a Ugandan. I was sparring him. I was still amateur. And all I remember was getting banged right hand, and I dropped. And I was sat down, sitting down. And I got up and I carried on the spar, and we got out and went on the bag, tapping a bag. And I had a big fight against Timothy Bradley at the Hilton. It was England versus America. And so I knew when I was fighting, it was in like a week's time or something. So I went on the scale to check my weight, and Tony Burns, the head coach, the legend, said, "When are you fighting next?" And I went, I don't know. He goes, "Where are you going now?" I went, "Home." He goes, "Where'd you live?" I went, "I don't know.
It's the same thing that
movie. Oh, it was terrible. I remember getting in the car, I was puking up on my arm and everything. I was really bad.
I was downstairs in the changing rooms. So just some guy using the gym coming down. I thought he hit me on the side. I was starting on my
You need your cheesecake.
Yeah. Wait, listen, just quickly, did you beat me, Bradley?
No, he beat me by 2 points.
Anyway, right, so if you want to...
Do that knockout.
If you want to press request to chat, come up and ask me a question or ask us whatever you want to ask us, because we've got a glove sitting here signed by Lee.
They're all shy, aren't they? Always shy, you lot.
Yeah, you've got to come up and ask us or tell us the answer that Lee's already give you, and we will send you that glove. Darren Barker's been a bit slack on sending the gloves out. But
they went out today. I've got receipts somewhere proving they went registered delivery, so they're on their way. Trust me. Oh, Ben Bishop, look, smiley face. Look, come up here, Ben. Come on, I want to hear. You. Surely you've got.
We sent you the other glove off Ben as well.
Right. Okay. Let's go here. What speed work do you do most?
Mainly with the pads.
On the pad.
Pad work, yeah.
I tell you what, you stole the show at.
Yeah.
Stole the show at the Anthony Joshua workout at your court. It was unbelievable. Yeah. You have to remind me the coach's name.
Tony Ball.
Tony Ball.
Blimey. I mean, it was, you talk about Floyd Mayweather, yeah. Right? It was very similar, but he had the crowd going, ooh.
So I've been with him since day one, since I turned pro. And like we work well.
Yeah, you can see that though, just the way he was over. Yeah. It's not like he's even got a call to shots out. He's just like, everything's just, yeah.
Ben really Bishop cool. agrees. And there was one more, but okay. Oh, what part of training do you enjoy the most?
The spine.
Yeah, I enjoy it. Yeah.
And like, I enjoy the long runs as well, like up in the countryside.
All you Welshmen love the runs though, man.
It's oh, just, in the valleys.
All the hills. There's not too many hills around here.
No.
Is there not?
What do you think of Liam Walsh as a potential opponent? Is he ready for
what weight is he? An opponent for me?
I don't know.
He's a weight above, isn't he?
Is he right above?
I boxed his brother, Ryan Walsh.
Yeah.
And yeah.
He'd give any featherweight at all.
Really?
Yeah.
Did I miss out on the glove, Darren? I don't.
No, you've got to come up.
You've got to come up, mate. Come up. I don't know if you've logged in yet or anything, but you've got to log in. Request a chat up there somewhere, and then you can answer the question and ask Lee and us to a question. But what are we on now?
We are moving on, mate. Other news. What's going on in the world of boxing?
Loads going on, aren't we?
Yeah,
let's
talk about
your mate.
Was it?
Smith,
the kid from Leeds.
Oh, Warrington.
Oh, Warrington.
My mate. I'm going to back him up.
What did you think of his fight?
Crap.
Yeah.
It was a good fight to watch, but they were evenly matched. But that Japanese guy won very good. They don't travel very well.
No.
And he come over on the Wednesday before the fight.
Mm.
And like it showed in the fight.
I know you've got the world title and you're looking for the big fights. Does that fight appeal to you?
Yeah.
I know, you know, it's a big domestic fight, isn't
it? Nothing that would, yeah.
It's a big domestic fight, and he's just been off and off and like slating some of my performances. Like he slated me against Fernando Montiel. I'm a last fight, and he's saying that I think I'm better than I am.
Would you travel to Leeds to fight him?
I'll fight him anyway.
Yeah. Yeah,
nice. I'll beat him anyway as well. I'll beat him on the moon.
Yeah, so, I mean, that was that fight. Then who else we had? We had Martin Ward on the
bill. Yeah.
You might have fought Wardy as well.
Yeah.
Martin Ward. Yeah, love Wardy.
Yeah, Martin Ward, he put in a great fight. He's getting better, if I'm honest. I think Martin just needs to sort of, the distance, he overdoes the distance a little bit, because when you see Martin Maud in the gym, this kid's phenomenal, isn't he? He just like excels, doesn't he, in the gym?
Yeah,
he moves too far with his feet.
Yeah, that's exactly what happened on the last one. The guy went in to throw a body shot, and he crashed it. It was horrible cut.
When he boxed Maxi, he was almost knocked himself off.
Yeah,
right.
He's unbelievable inspiring.
Oh, he's unbelievable inspiring. I've seen him so many times. He looks brilliant.
He's getting there, though, isn't he?
He's slowly getting there. And if he can get it right, I believe the kid's going to go right, a long way.
Right. Chris Hicks. That's wrong, mate. Who did Lee beat to win the British battle? And you need to come on and answer the question.
Yeah, so
right,
top
okay.
right-hand corner.
We got here? What else we got here? How much road work do you do before a fight? And when do you stop or cut down the road work?
I don't really cut down the road work. I just switch it to the running machine when it's a bit closer to the fight.
Yeah.
Just to prevent any injuries.
Right.
And like the minimum I run is like 5 miles.
Minimum.
Yeah.
Well, that was my long Sunday, wasn't it?
I run between like 5 and 8 miles every day. And like,
that's good.
And like one long one, maybe like 10 or 12.
What would your training like? So if you was in full training, what would your training can be? How many times a day would you train, and how many days a week?
On a Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, I do like my road work and the boxing gym, like squaring up, pads or whatever, and then like cardio in the evening, just at the local leisure centre. Then the Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday, we do our strength and conditioning in the morning, boxing at dinner time, and then cardio in the evening.
Right.
So 3 times a day, 6 days a week.
Yeah. It's good.
Right, just as we've got these, who wraps your hands up? Who wraps your hands before a fight?
Chris Seneca.
Chris, yeah.
Have you been with Chris from the beginning?
From the beginning, yeah.
Yeah,
he's a great
experience. He's a really cool guy.
He used to work with my dad, he must have told you.
Yeah, on the markets.
They used to sit on the markets. Yeah. My dad and Chris worked with each other. Chris sold
fabrics and all that, yeah, in the beginning.
Yeah, that's it. And my dad sold clothes, women's clothes. Yeah. And loads of bras and knickers around the house.
Should have let Alex read.
If you could share a ring with any boxer in history, regardless of weight class, who would it be? Darren Jones. Could have asked that if you'd come on down, but
I don't know. Maybe Sugar Ray Robinson.
He's the best ever. He's the best ever.
So they say. So it'd be good to see how good he really was.
Yeah, good question though, that. Back to the news of last week.
We got Errol Spence KOs, Algerian, 5 rounds. Yeah, that was some performance. We was getting there doing that, weren't we, together? This kid can fight, man. I don't know Errol Spence. He can really fight. They're talking about him boxing Kell Brook. I don't think he's got a big enough name, really, because I think he's a real danger.
I think that was a fight eliminator for Brook, wasn't it?
So Brook's going to have to take that fight. That's a dangerous fight, man.
I seen him box in Cardiff as an amateur. He boxed Fred Evans from my gym.
Did he beat Fred?
He stopped him with a body shot.
Yeah.
Fred Evans can fight. Elite as an amateur.
Yeah. Didn't he win a medal in the Olympics?
He won a silver in the Olympics.
Yeah, in 2012.
Wow. European champion. Yeah. He's won everything.
Yeah. But your old foe, Stephen Smith, as well, was he top of the bill that night? I think he was.
Yeah.
Against Pedraza.
Danny Russell Jr. was top of the bill. He was... Chief Sport, wasn't
it? Right, that's it.
What did you make of that?
He boxed very, very well. No shame in losing to that Pedraza.
He was a great fighter.
Yeah. He had one of the best jabs. Mm. He got the best jab apart from mine.
Yeah.
He had a really, nice. Really good jab. Yeah. Really sharp, fast.
Would you fight Pedraza?
No. if I moved up in weight, I would, yeah.
Well, who else did we have in here then?
We've got Stuart Hall.
Stuart Hall was on the bill back in Leeds. Sorry, forgot about Stuart Hall, didn't we? That was a good fight with Guerrero, wasn't it?
So, it was a tough fight for him. That they just both stood toe to toe, didn't they? And it was a fight that he had to really dig deep to do and keep his career alive, really. Because if he lost that fight, career was virtually over. It was finished. Do you know what I mean? Because he would never have got back to the top again. He had to drop down to boxing at British level. And I mean, you'll know once you come off that world title stage, you start going back down boxing with British levels. Who wants to do that?
Yeah, it's too hard of a sport, isn't it?
Yeah. I think that was the best fight on the bill.
He got cut, didn't he? I think it was a Guerrero. And Guerrero got cut and he just come alive. He started firing. The work rate was for they both went at. I'd like to see how many punches they threw.
He's old as well, isn't he? I think he's 35, is it?
Yeah.
Hey, man, when you look at him as well, I was sat there with Tony Sims, and if, say, there was a blacked out that Guerrero or any Mexican was blacked out, you would know they were Mexican, wouldn't you? Yeah, the way they throw punches and the way they shape up, they're just so typically Mexican, aren't they?
He's massive for a bantamweight as well, Stuart.
He's like 5'8".
Yeah, he's a big lump.
All right, look, Chris Hicks hasn't got a webcam, so he can't come on. But look, ping that answer then, and you can be the winner of the glove. Unless someone comes up, you can be the winner because everyone seems.
I have noticed people like Ben Bishop who won a glove before. He's on there at the moment.
There's a few on there.
So if one of you wants to come up,
there you go, Chris. Well, unless someone comes up,
you won it, Chris. So let's see what happens. But let's moving on, mate. Moving on. Now every week, Mr. Barker does a little quick fire question round with his little brown book.
Look at the questions, mate.
You won't know nothing about this because you've not seen the show before, but it's quite funny. Your brother's going to be over there pissing himself.
You've done me last week, didn't you? He flipped it on me.
Yeah, flipped it on him. So.
Right, are you ready? Just quick as you can.
Quick fire round coming up.
No passing. But they're not that bad, right? They're simple. Early bird or night owl?
Early bird.
Dancing or singing?
Neither.
Dance and singing, all night.
I can't dance.
What have a beer?
I don't drink.
All right, cats or dogs?
Dogs.
Beard or clean shaven?
Beard.
Fruit or veg?
Fruit.
Money or fame?
Money.
World title or 5 million cash?
5 million cash.
Love that answer.
Call or text?
Huh?
Call or text?
Text.
White bread or brown bread?
Brown.
Blonde or brunette?
Either.
What, you like bald-headed women?
Ferrari or Lambo?
Not either. Ferrari.
Christmas or birthday?
Christmas.
Beach or pool?
Beach.
Fries or the fat chips?
I don't know. McDonald's fries are nice, isn't it? Fries.
Right. Boobs or ass?
Either.
Looks or personality?
Looks.
Window or aisle seat?
Window.
Yes, there is.
Only a little couple of passes there.
Half moody, that.
But if I'm honest, that was one of the coolest ones we've had, if I'm honest.
It was very...
People do sort of melt a little bit when we do that. So I think we've done well there.
Right, sorry, mate. South American fighters and all that all seem to be harder now.
That's because we're all snugged up.
Like those from South Wales, boyo. So someone saying, you Welsh mob. Just saying you're as hard as Mexicans.
Yeah,
it's pretty cool.
We've got to say, this weekend, we've got GGG, haven't we? Gennady Golovkin, the man who avoided me.
He's actually got your old title.
My old IBF title. He's fighting Dominic Wade, who is unbeaten.
He retired. Eight,
yeah. Joel's offered that fight. We said it before. $300,000, Eddie said. And I went, I'll have it. I've just lost Martinez. I went, I'll fight him 100%. My trainer Tony went, you won't fight him. I retired, I went up to him and went, nice one for not letting me fight him.
Dominic Wade's unbeaten, 18 fights, 12 KOs.
His best win's over Sam Solomon. He's going to destroy him.
He ain't got to the level, if I'm honest. He's got a good jab.
But you may have blocked him.
He's just too good for his own good. You can't get no name in class.
He's going to have to step up.
I think he's a 20-1 on. That's the biggest odds I've seen, I think, since...
Since I fought Martinez, that was ridiculous.
Was it?
Oh, it was nuts. 33-1 or something.
What, you was your
underdog? Oh, massive. Really? I was
doing all right as well.
Yeah, my
team was buckled at the end, yeah.
Old guess, 1790, Fat Chips Forever.
Yeah, nice.
Sweet potato. Barry's Welsh Cakes.
That's cool.
Cup of tea and Welsh Rabbit. Cheese and toast. Love it. He's a foodie, he is. Guess 1790, he's a proper foodie.
So, right, listen, last chance before we...
Because Chris is going to nick this. He's going to nick this by the skin of his teeth. He ain't got a webcam.
So one of you want to press request a chat, come up and we will pull you up on the screen. Come and get the glove signed by Lee Selby. We've got Lee's younger brother, Andrew.
All right,
Let's get him in.
So, Andrew, when are you fighting next, mate?
14th of May.
14th of May, who you got?
Lewis Norman.
Yeah.
Yeah. He was English champion. He lost his title to Charlie Edwards.
Yeah. So, what's the age difference between you two?
Year and 2 months.
Year and 2 months. So, you started out after?
Right.
Who started?
He went first. I went about a couple of months after.
And was you sparring pretty much straight away with each other?
Before. We were sparring in the house.
Yeah. What is that? Your dad, the referee?
Yeah, that's it.
What age was you when you very first started?
8 when I went to the gym first.
Yeah. Blimey, you started really young then, didn't
first
you?
First fight to soon as well.
I think getting the gym, I must have been training with my dad, like sparring with my dad, like you say, when I was about 8, 9, 10, 11. But I didn't get in the gym until I was about 11 or 12.
When did you have your first fight?
12, I think. I was 12, something like that.
I had mine on my 11th birthday. There'd be 11 in the box.
Really?
There's a spare.
My first part was
a
spare.
And I boxed a giant and I won on a split. Oh, it was so hard, man. It was just so hard. And he'd had 4 and lost them all.
Sorry, guess 1843. Now, we're doing a head-to-head next week, aren't we, Spen?
Yeah, head-to-head's coming up
next week. We've just had a lot on at the minute, but they're coming up. And they're coming too thick and fast, but don't worry. And we want you lot to pick what head-to-heads you want us to do. And remember, the loser has to jump out an aeroplane.
I think next week we had Soccer AM, didn't we?
Soccer AM. We were at the Sky Studios doing the goal thing, which I've got to get revenge on Spencer because he beat me the penalties. But back to you, Andrew. How many fights did you have? Would you know? As an
amateur? I remember.
Who had more? It would have been you.
Twice. Close to 300 fights, I think.
300?
Yeah.
Like an elite international level.
So you but how many titles did you win as, you know, national titles?
Every year I win the Welsh, I win.
Yeah.
5 British. 2 European gold back to back, 2 bronze.
Blimey.
World silver and world bronze.
Senior.
Yeah.
And loads of different international tournaments then.
Unbelievable.
Gold medals. Then lost to the gold medalist in the Olympics.
She'd done a little bit as an amateur.
She'd done a little bit.
That's what it's so punchy, though.
Watch
me on
Channel 5.
May 14th, and this is the future star. I was going to ping it around here.
Yeah, go on, plug his Twitter thing.
How far is your brother going?
All the way.
Honestly.
as long as he stays dedicated and working hard, though he is.
Yeah, listen,
he could be one of the best Welsh boxers
ever. I think so. I think that.
Do you agree with that? Do you agree with that, Andrew?
Is amateur record?
Yeah,
anyone from Wales.
Yeah.
So
I got the skills. Just
you're dedicated, aren't you?
No, I didn't used to be as much of an eye.
Do you enjoy the sport? Or is it purely a job for you?
I enjoy getting paid.
Yeah, well, look, that's a job. It is a job at the end of the day, isn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, it is. That's the reason we did it all. I mean, especially someone like yourself, who's had that many amateur fights, and you've won that many medals and badges and whatever.
You want some gold with it.
You want to get something out of it, and you deserve it, didn't you? Mm. But brilliant to have you on, mate. Yeah. That's quality. The future champ. So one more time, plug it.
What's that?
The fight. Plug the fight. Go on.
Channel 5, 40 for me. Follow me on Twitter at Andrew Selby 1.
That's it. He's a future champ.
He's the current champ. We got the current champ back on, Mr. Lee Selby. Cheesecake
Eater. Have you got a nickname?
Lightning
Lee Selby.
I was called everything. The Welsh movie, Lee Super Selby. Lightning Lee Selby.
Cheesecake
Boy. Big one. The Bunny Boy Assassin.
The Barry Boy Assassin.
I don't know where they come from. I see no boxer at the Barry Boy Assassin.
That's wicked.
So, I know what you mean when it says the nicknames.
Well, listen, I don't think anybody's going to come up, mate. I don't think anybody's going to come up requesting.
Oh, Lee and Andrew, football or rugby?
We're Welsh, but rugby.
Rugby boy. Right. It looks like, Chris, you've won it, mate. Because they're all bottle jobs on here. Come on, I can't believe it. Right. Chris, you've got to ping your address to the live show at yahoo.com, and we'll get that glove over to you.
I think that pretty much wraps up the week, if I'm honest. Next week, we're going to be back to doing our head-to-head. So we're going to be at the Soccer AM Studios, where I'm going to kick Darren's ass again of football, which is embarrassing, because I've never kicked a ball since I was 11. Darren claims to be semi-pro. I kicked his ass last time. So I think that's pretty much wraps
quick
it up.
One, I want to say, straight down that lens, you've got a message for Josh Warrington. I'm just sticking it on you. Actually, I want to bring it closer. Look, this is serious.
Well, he's slated a few of my previous performances. And I said, you wasn't world class, and I am. So when you're in the ring, all those little shots you've been hitting your opponents with, they'll be landing, they'll be missing me, and I'll be hitting you. Easy work.
You heard it there. Easy work. Well, look, that was a blinding show.
So Chris Hicks needs the email
again.
Thank you
very much, mate.
Just give Chris the email again before I wrap this little baby up.
Oh, sorry, right. The live show. If you go onto our Twitter, you'll see it anyway. The live show at yahoo.com. All you got to do is ping your address on there. We've got your name. And we'll ping that out. You'll probably get it in about a fortnight, the way I've been carrying on. For Spencer. Doesn't ever pull his finger out. I'm on the postman. Used to be a postman, so I suppose it's fitting.
Yeah, that's even worse than
I was a postman for a year and a half.
I'm starting to feel embarrassed.
I was at the West End, like Oxford Street and all that, yeah.
So now you made me feel embarrassed down the other side. I'm starting to feel embarrassed.
Also, you can watch our videos, all our shows, the previous shows, all the head-to-heads on our archives. They're there and you can tune in. Just go on Mimi TV, or you can go on the live shows on the Twitter and follow the link and it will take you on there. And all our shows are on there and they're spending. Yeah. We've got some other news regards to the phone.
The iPhone. So we've got an app coming up. It should be built anytime within the next month. It's been built. It's all done. We're just waiting to...
Go on your phone and you can take part.
So we're waiting for it to get approved by Apple. It's all done. So it will be up and you can get it on your iPhone, your iPad. You can get it on any device you want. So we'll be expecting the figures to go through the roof. We really appreciate every week you lot tuning in. The figures are growing and growing by a couple of thousand every week. People watching it on the archives as well. So really appreciate that. But I think it's come to an end, mate. It's come to an end. Been wicked down here in Wales. I tell you what, going down to Barry Island, that was an experience.
That was
really cool as well. We ended up in some brilliant little coffee cove cafe and met some wicked people. So that was really cool. Thanks to them. But from myself, Spencer Oliver.
Me, Darren Barker.
Lightning, Lisa.
Really? Lightning. Remember lightning?
Like that. This is
the live show.